Baseball is making its first appearance in the Olympics, and although it's only a demonstration sport, they are playing with the same enthusiasm as any other sport here. The crowd numbered in excess of 50,000 at Dodger Stadium for the U.S. team's game with the Dominican Republic.
Presents Spirit of Excellence, the 1984 Los Angeles Olympic Games, and the match between the United States of America and Korea in baseball.
Fans from all over the country and all over the world turning out for what should be a very interesting day.
Well over 50,000 in attendance. We're at the semifinal round, Korea and the USA. The USA so far has won all three of its games in this demonstration tournament.
Americans have just been outstanding so far, Corey. Game number one against Taipei, victorious 2-1. Then they got things rolling. Game number two, they beat the Italians 16-1. Bankhead was the winning pitcher in that one. And then in game number three, they beat the Dominican Republic by a final score of 12-0. So you're going to see an American team that so far has a team batting average of 353. Rod Dedeaux, the coach, coming in, said, we got some power and we got some pitching too. They have not allowed an earned run so far. There you have it, the United States team ready to come out here for the top half of the first inning at Dodger Stadium. What a picture perfect early evening for baseball activity. Taking a look at the United States lineup, Mark McGwire out of the University of Southern California, the nation's leader with 32 home runs during this past season. Pretty good defensive player at first, too. Flavio Alfaro, the young man who played shortstop during his college days, now at second base. Gary Green of Oklahoma State, another shortstop playing at short. And from Brigham Young, Cory Snyder, another shortstop who Dedeaux has moved over to third base. Out of the outfield, Shane Mack of UCLA. Many people think he is the best prospect for the pros in the nation. Or it could be this man, Oddibe McDowell out of Arizona State. A Ricky Henderson-type ball player, small, only 5'10", but he hits with power, great speed as well. Name look familiar? Chris Gwynn. That is Tony Gwynn of the San Diego Padres' younger brother. They both went to San Diego State, both of them great ball players. Out of North Carolina, B.J. Surhoff, an exceptional catcher, regarded as one of the top three catchers in the nation. And also out of North Carolina, the University of North Carolina, and from the North Carolina area, Ashboro, North Carolina, 21-year-old Scott Bankhead, and he already has shown that he could do it.
Undefeated in 10 games for North Carolina, the best pitcher in the ACC, had an ERA during the college season of 1.67. Here's a kid who has a lot of talent. He sure pitches like a veteran. He was undefeated this past year with an overall record of 10-0. In 83, he was 9-0, and he's ahead on the count against Soon-Chul Lee. Leadoff batter here at Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. That one's popped up. Alfaro back. Oh, that's going, but he holds on. Jams him a little bit. Cory Snyder will be there. Bankhead pitch. There's a look at the slider. Pokes it out. Here's McDowell on the run. Makes the catch. So Bankhead has the Koreans go quietly at the top half of inning number one. Beautiful day. The smog really hasn't been a factor.
And from a wide shot, it looks almost as if the Cleveland Indians are playing the Montreal Expos, doesn't it, George? The colors of the uniform?
The Expos uniform certainly very reminiscent of the United States. Here's a line drive, right center field. Look, center field, there's Park there to make the catch. That'll bring up Will Clark. Oh, look at the power of this lineup. Clark with 25 home runs. McGwire with 32. Snyder with 23. Oddibe McDowell with 23 during the college season. Oh, gets him this time, though. Clark goes down swinging. So for the United States in inning number one, no runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left at the end of one. We're scoreless. There's a line drive. That will fall in front of Gwynn in right field. It's one ball. Second batter here in the second inning, Yong-Kuk Kim. There he goes. He's got him. Perfect throw, and they nail Kang-Don Lee trying to steal second, so there's one out. There's a ground ball. Cory Snyder will come up with it. His throw over to McGwire is in time.
Pitching very well. Hitting the corners, not giving the Korean hitters anything too good to hit so far.
There's a line shot to right center. That'll drop, maybe extra bases. McDowell cuts it off and gets the throw in. He'll hold him to second.
Right on cue there, George. As I mentioned, he wasn't giving the Koreans anything too good to hit. Get their first extra base hit.
Try to get something going. Here's a line drive to center field. McDowell want to come up and throw, but they hold the runner at third.
American outfit is not playing all that deep because this Korean team is not the kind of team that's going to beat you with power. They're going to single and double you to death.
There's a line drive. Nice stab by Snyder. Cory Snyder comes up with it on one knee. They choke off a rally. That would have been one run, definitely, maybe more, if it rolled down the line. Good left-handed stab. Mark McGwire, who's played here at Dodger Stadium, and he's the first baseman for the University of Southern California. They play the Dodgers in an exhibition game every year. McGwire goes reaching for this one. In Hobake will have to hurry. He got him. Nice play, Cory.
Collins averaged over three seasons at Brigham Young, 432. He's hit over 70 home runs in those three seasons, 240-some RBI.
In fact, he is second on the all-time home run list in college baseball with a total of 73. Jeff Ledbetter is number one, but Ledbetter did it for 4 years. Snyder has only had 3 years of competition. Gets caught in this one with the hands up on the tight pitch inside. Third baseman Yong-Kuk Kim collars that one. And there are two down here in the bottom half of inning number two. B.J. Surhoff out of North Carolina. The Tar Heel digs in. Pops this one up over to third base where Yong-Kuk Kim will put the squeeze on it. So for the United States, no runs, no hits, no errors, no one left. And after two, it is scoreless between the United States and Korea. Bankhead, one of 15 first-round draft picks. He's already signed with the Kansas City Royals. Big pops this one up. Will it fall? No, Bankhead is there to pick it off. Where was Billy Martin when you need him? Bankhead was there. Nice play.
McGwire, that was the body you saw flying from right to left on the screen. But Korea really hasn't hit all that well. 237 as a team in the three games coming into this contest. And perhaps they're breaking out of that slump, only averaging 3.3 runs a game.
If you're wondering what the sound is, it is the wave. Even in the Olympics, we have it making its way around Dodger Stadium. There it is. It's a two-and-a-half decker. Hasn't really reached the third deck. Here's a fly ball by Soon-Chul Lee. Back is Mack. And he brings it down for the second out. Nice camera work. We follow it everywhere.
That wave is rolling, isn't it?
I wonder if they have a wave in Korea.
I don't know. They may have it from now on as the Koreans get a look at it. The biggest cheer we've heard so far, I think.
Even the players are taking a moment to revel in the first wave of this Korean-United States game.
I'll bet the Koreans, if they hadn't seen it before, wondering what the heck it is, huh? So two quick outs for Bankhead as he gets Bake and Lee. That'll bring up Heung-Sik Park, the center fielder. This may be one of the longest waves of the season. They're still going.
Could be a record.
Scott Bankhead of Reidsville, North Carolina, the Reidsville High.
USA, if you can't make it out.
High bounder. This is going to be a close play. Bankhead's throw.
Ooh.
They say he got him.
Sure. Looked like a very, very close play. In fact, at first glance, looked like the runner had beat the throw.
Nice play by O. Oh, low throw, but they get green. Has looked strong so far in the first couple of innings here. Here's a pop-up, short right field. It looks like it's going to drop. A little bit of a mix-up between the second baseman and the right fielder, and the United States has its first hit of this game against Korea. The delivery. Oh! That one's out of here. And the United States has a 2-0 lead over Korea on Oddibe McDowell's two-run home run. And you can see those American fans celebrate.
Oddibe McDowell hearts one here in the third inning, his third home run of the tournament. This coming after two outs. A little base hit pop, the batter before by Alfaro, and McDowell takes it out. You see it right there. And he knew right away when he connected this ball was gone. You could see the expression on his face from the center field camera. Way up there, about halfway into the bleachers in right field. Watch a little bit of a Reggie Jackson look right there. He knows it right there. That baby's gone. McDowell gets it. Congratulations to the USA dugout. It's 2-0 near the third inning of play.
The mistake cost him. And the United States has a 2-0 lead. That one got out of here pronto, which brings up the whole discussion of the aluminum bat issue, which now there's a move in college baseball to go back to the wooden bats. Chris Gwynn, 0-1. Here's a young man as the wave rolls around Dodger Stadium again. They've got three and almost four deaths now. Chris Gwynn set an NCAA record this past year with 137 hits, but he's not going to get one this time as Oh gets him swinging. This is a young man, Bankhead, who had exceptional success against this Korean team when they did play in Durham, North Carolina. One hit over six innings is all he allowed, and he also struck out 13 in that outing. He was impressive, and I'm sure that had a lot to do with why Rod Dedeaux named him to pitch this evening here at Dodger Stadium. Nice slider. There's a perfect look at his slider dipping away, and he missed that one by a good 3 or 4 inches.
I'm sure now with a two-run lead after that one shaky inning in the second, that Bankhead will...
Ooh, he gets him here.
Do what he did just there.
Jams him. Snyder, bad throw. And he'll go all the way to second base. There's a line drive over McGwire's outstretched glove. And the throw to the plate will be up the line. He's safe.
And the ball gets away, the runner goes down to second base, and Kim, the number one hitter on this Korean club, comes through with the base hit in the clutch situation.
The shadow is now almost completely engulfing the infield, and there is the second strikeout for Scott Bankhead.
Since 1962, George, more than 55 million people have watched baseball in this stadium. Amazing.
Amazing, but consider the fact that there are some 100 million people that play the game of baseball around the world. That's one of the reasons why people in the International Federation and the United States Baseball Federation are trying to get it into the Olympics. 20 million alone here in the United States play the game of baseball. Pops him up. We'll see if McGwire can make the play. It's on the edge of the infield warning track. Pulls it down. And that'll do it at the end of 3.5. Clark lines this one out to left field. Will it drop? Nice play by the charging left fielder, Soon-Chul Lee. Mark McGwire, the first baseman, next up. They got him reaching to ground out the first time up. There they are again. And it's a little tap. The third baseman cuts it off. And they tag him. Nice play. Snyder's a kind of ball player that will go with the pitch. That's why he's regarded so highly. In addition to his strength, he'll pull the ball when he gets it. He'll go the other way. Bounces this one off the plate out to second base. Should be an easy play. And that'll do it for the United States in the bottom of inning number 4. This one popped into short left field. Will it fall? Nice play by Green. Green and Mack almost got tangled up again. It's a nice catch change coming in. Almost tackles him. That's a tough play to make. Had a string of 17 scoreless innings snapped when Korea scored that unearned run in the fourth inning. And this is one of the reasons. The top pitcher in the Atlantic Coast Conference the last 2 years. There's a shot to left field. And that'll make the sixth throw. And we've got a tie ball game here in inning number 5. Soon-Chul Lee. Look at a grin on his face. And the helmet down to his nose. The Koreans in the crowd here ecstatic with this ball game. It's all knotted up. And talk about a frozen rope. This thing is about 12 feet off the ground all the way. Watch it one more time. It's a real crunch. Boom, right there. And look where that pitch was.
Right down the pipe.
Right about letter high. And just as we say that their scoreless string was broken, that now breaks the earned run streak. Oh, look at that. What a nice, neat way to put your dogs on the bench. That's a first. Usually they just crumble up and stuff it in their pockets. Back pocket, right? So we're tied 2-2 now here in the top half of the fifth inning. There's a line drive to left. Will it stay fair? It does, right in front of the official. Mack will get the ball into second base. A nice throw, but still standing on second with a double is Heung-Sik Park. Ki-Woong Kang. 0-for-2, flying out and struck out. Hasn't been able to touch Bankhead so far. That one is low and in the dirt. The runner will advance to third. And it's clear that Bankhead has lost his rhythm, no doubt about it.
Looks a little shaky. He has now given up 6 hits. With 2 out in the sixth inning, Rod goes out to the mound.
You just don't quite have that good rhythm, young fella. Don't quite just have it. Okay. Want the right-hander. It's all right. Just watch it.
The right-hander, Don August, will come in, and there's a little bit of insight of what transpires on the mound as Ron Dedeaux talks to Scott Bankhead.
He missed some low pitches on it. This guy's not a low-ball umpire.
August has really come on in the last 2 years to be one of the best pitching prospects in the nation. There's a ground ball to third. Cory Snyder gobbles it. Gets this throw down perfect. But the Koreans do some damage. It's a brand new ball game. We're tied at 2 apiece. Ground ball left side. Back to that same third base area. Easy play. One up, one down. Gets him to pop this one up. Waving everybody off and will collar it. A 2-2 ball game, bottom half of inning number 5. This one might drop right center field, and it does. If that had been a wooden bat, it probably would have been a broken bat, single to right, but with the aluminum bats,
They don't break too often, do they, George? That only the third hit given up by O. U.S. club outscored competition coming in this game by 30-2 margin. We also should throw in the fact that they had a pre-Olympic tour where they played 32 games. And the Olympic team won 27 of those 32 games, losing four and tying one, which is a pretty good mark. Talk to some of these athletes, they think that turning pro and being in the minor league is going to be a cakewalk compared to the schedule they just went through. Different city almost every night. There goes Green, but that's the inning. Alfaro goes down on strikes. And at the end of five, we have a 2-2 ball game. Alaska, Cape Cod, great amateur baseball in the summer. Colorado, most of the top major players will play in one of those premier leagues. Lee goes down on strikes. He got him. Two straight strikeouts. I don't like it one bit, but the fans do. Line drive, left field, that'll be a base hit. And the Koreans have something going. Keeping him close. McGwire yelled over to August, say, let's not forget him over here. He's the go-ahead run. The stretch by the Chapman College pitcher. Line drive, base hit, right field. Gwynn comes up throwing. And they've got him trapped off second. Heung-Suk Kim is nailed on a picture-perfect baseball play. George, they've gone full count to the center fielder, Oddibe McDowell. They don't want him on, but that's where he's going to be. High and inside, McDowell is on. And now whatever discussion Dedeaux had with Gwynn will probably come to fruition. Because McDowell can steal a base. He's got great speed. Gwynn can control the bat. Chung-Ok Kim knows full well he's got to get something going here to cut off this rally. We're tied 2-2. Chris Gwynn to the plate, who's 0-2. Struck out and flied out. Led the nation in base hits this year with a total of 137. Also set an NCAA record for at-bats as well as base hits. He's not going, but Gwynn is squaring around. And Oddibe McDowell will take his lead. Oh, into the stretch. He's going. He's got it stolen. Good jump by Oddibe McDowell. Good shot of Rod. Give an idea how long Rod's been around. Sparky Anderson, manager of the Detroit Tigers, was once a bat boy for Rod many years ago on this USC team.
They kid and say every year he's going to retire, but they've been saying that for the last 20 years, and he somehow sticks around. And certainly this was one of his lifetime goals, to see this as an exhibition sport, and even more importantly, to get baseball into the Olympics. And maybe by the time we get to Korea and this Korean team is participating, it'll be there for real.
Here's a ground ball. It could go through. That'll score McDowell, and the United States will have a lead. That brings the crowd to its feet here at Dodger Stadium, and the flags are up and waving. Chung-Ok Kim is up off the bench now to the edge of the steps. Nobody's going. There's ball four. Runners on first and second, and that'll bring up Mark McGwire, the big first baseman. And it'll also bring Kim out of the dugout to talk to his pitcher. And Chung-Ok Kim has not moved from that position all game long, has he? A little nervous. His pitcher, Myong-Lok Oh, with the full count. Pressure pitch, but Gwynn gets the third. Pressure pitch as he gets McGwire, but the runners will advance, as again, Dedeaux has something working. Just could not get the bat on the ball. So even though McGwire strikes out, they do what they wanted to do, get the runners to second and third.
As good as a bunt. Now it's up to Cory Snyder.
There's a line drive. Straightaway center field. It'll drop. One run will score. Two runs will score. Snyder comes through with the big hit. And on second and third, drives a low fastball. And Heung-Sik Park did not draw a bead on his baseball early enough. Has to go back, retrieve the ball off the wall. By that time, two runners come home standing up. A stand-up double for Cory Snyder. The USA takes a three-run lead.
Those two runners scoring, Park and Gwynn. And the look and the motion by Cory Snyder at second base told it all as he motors into second. And Chung-Hok Kim will come out. That probably will be all for Myong-Lok Oh. Here's a delivery to Surhoff.
Fly ball right field. Snyder is tagging. He'll try to go to third. Here's the throw. It'll be close. They say he made it. Lee's throw. A little high and wide up the line. And this is what makes the American team so tough. Even these guys who can hit and hit for power like Snyder can run the bases. Here the tag, the throw by Lee. He skies a little bit too much. Pretty close play. Had to throw it on the mark. Would have been an exceptionally close play. Safe at third base. Snyder is in there. As you see that close replay.
Whoever wins here will go on to play Japan. That game is already completed. Japan advanced. And down swinging goes Mack. So for the United States, they wrap it up in the bottom of the sixth, picking up three runs. And after six, they lead the Koreans by a score of 5-2. A lot of these United States athletes, I'm sure, will be seeing in the coming years in the minor and major league levels of professional ball. This one slammed into the ground. Snyder. Oh, another low throw, but this one will go against McGwire. Took his eye off it momentarily. And that'll be the third error for the United States.
McGwire knows he has no excuse here. Snyder, plenty of time, measures the throw and fires. A little bit low, but still an easy catch. First base coach gives us a signal.
Beautiful evening for baseball. 8 days of demonstration competition have been every bit the success that everybody had hoped. Ground ball. Green knocks it down. But there'll be runners on first and second, and the Koreans have something working here. Bullpen gets cranking once again. Soon-Chul Lee with Heung-Sik Park, the center fielder, on deck. Crowd is quieted for one of the few times this evening. Haven't had a wave for about 2 innings.
They're due for a wave, I think, George. I can feel it.
Surhoff rolls through the signals once again. Oh, that one was by him. He was fooled. By the time he got the bat off the shoulder, it was in Surhoff's glove. So there's one out.
Way late. Had no chance of getting that ball.
Dedeaux is very fortunate to have pitchers like August that can come back on 1 day or 2 days rest. And just about everybody on his staff has been able to do that. Exceptional staff. Ground ball right side. Gonna go for two. They have one. Safe at first. First and third with two outs. Good pivot here, just fast legs.
They turned it well. Runner just beat it out.
Ki-Woong Kang, who is hitless on the day, flies this one to right field. Gwynn is on his horse and will take it in stride.
So the United States, faced with a no-out, two-on situation, gets out of it behind Don August. And after 6.5 innings, the United States continues to lead the Korean team by a score of 5-2. Gary Green of Oklahoma State to lead it off, lines it back up the middle. Kang with a nice play. The cutoff which could have been a base hit.
George, you were right, the wave has returned.
Back in action. There are some fans here that are fans of international baseball. There's a good bunt, but a nice play. We've got a substitution coming in for the United States for Oddibe McDowell. Larkin will come in. Barry hitting 167, coming in 1-for-6 in competition. Out of Cincinnati, Ohio, against Park. Young man out of Michigan. Hit 352 as a sophomore, then 370 as a junior. A 359 career average. He could swing the bat. Gets in front of this one, but it's curving foul. Larkin's been up 6 times so far in the tournament. One hit to show for his appearances, one RBI. Big Ten Player of the Year, 1984. Outstanding fielder as well, one of the best fielders in the nation. Park's delivery. Ooh, just wide. So far, George, I think we'd have to say that Oddibe McDowell might be our player of the game with the home run back in the third inning. And, of course, the walk and the stolen base in the sixth, which got that three-run inning rolling.
Could be Gwynn. Gwynn had the great throw. And as it stands right now, he would have the go-ahead RBI, the game-winning RBI. Larkin, 6 foot, 180 pounds, also can motor. He's stolen 27 of 33 bases in his career. Faces the full count with two outs here in the bottom of the seventh against Park. Just gets a piece of that. You get the feeling as you look around the stadium that people are just enjoying this experience of demonstration baseball in the Olympics. It has been nothing but positive vibes all week long here at Dodger Stadium. He may beat this one out. A high chopper. Big throw. Just in time. And a nice scoop by Kim over at first base. So, that's it for the United States in the bottom half of the seventh inning. Nothing across. Good play by Bates. And a nice stretch. The U.S. still leads, heading to the eighth inning by a score of 5-2 over the Koreans.
The whole city, the whole Southern California area is just excited to be a part of this whole Olympic experience as Alfaro throws out Lee. It's been a lot of fun, George.
Here's a ground ball to third. Snyder, off-balance throw, gets it. Yong-Suk Kim, the high man in the hit parade for Korea so far with two. Alfaro will snap this one up. And the United States will go to the bottom of the eighth with that three-run lead holding intact. Fly
ball gets pretty good meat on it to the warning track. And Park will collar it in. Will Clark looking for his first hit on this day against the Koreans. Very calm player at the plate. Grinds this one into the ground. It rolls into right field. He'll get one. He's going to try for two. Here's the throw. He slides. He's safe. Does he stay on the bag? Fake puts the tag on him. He thinks he got him off the bag. Now hold on. Here's Kim. Kim comes over. And I think Kim's been thrown out of the game. It looks as if he put his hand on the umpire. Let's look at it again, Corey, on the replay.
Good heads-up play by Clark, first of all, hustling in because the center fielder was playing very deep, slides in safely, but the hand appears to have gone off the bag. Fake applies the tag. Looks like he's out. Now watch it again from center field. There's the tag. Clark sliding beyond second base, and from the right of your screen, you will see the third baseman, Kim, come in and push the umpire right there. Clark is fired up. The umpire says, you can't push me around, you're gone.
There's almost a delayed reaction by the umpire. Then he finally realizes, hey, he pushed me. I better do something. I'm going to throw him out of the game. It didn't look as if it was a malicious push. He's just trying to say, look, over here. Obviously, he can't talk to him and explain to him that way. So maybe the only way he could think about doing it was, hey, look, this is what happened.
Chung-Hak Kim is out to talk about it.
So a little fireworks. The Yong-Kuk Kim will be out of the game, number six there.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah, come on here.
Let's go.
Umpire's trying to get things rolling. He will leave the game. Kim very reluctantly will leave the game. And here's a young man who is hitting over 300 for the demonstration tournament, so they can ill afford to lose his bat. Look, 5 for 16. You can see Bates' reaction there. He can't believe it. And Kim comes over, and as you can tell, as you said, George, not a malicious thing. Just wanted to say to the umpire, hey, this is what happened the way I saw it. You're wrong. And got carried away a little bit.
An unfortunate situation, and you can tell he's probably the most embarrassed player in the ballpark right now.
McGwire pops this one to the right side. The right fielder Lee will make the catch, and there are two down. As we started to say once before about Snyder, he's the kind of athlete that just has lightning in his bat. You get a picture of it right there. A line drive, shortstop. Bates gathers it in, and the United States rally is cut off. So Park survives another scare. We go to the top of the ninth inning with the United States on the smiling side of the scoreboard. A three-run lead, 5-2. And the Koreans with their last opportunity to even this one up. Jong-Doo Lee, the right fielder who already has two hits, goes up against Don August, who's been more or less in control since he took over for Bankhead.
I got to take a tough play here.
Nice bunt. Perfect bunt. Nice try by August. But he had no prayer on that one. Best opportunity would have been to just try to let it roll and hope for it to go out of bounds. But the way it is, no foul ball. It's a picture-perfect bunt. And the Koreans are alive. To 3-2 now against Kai Young Choi, the pinch hitter in the ninth inning. There's a line shot to left field. Will it drop? Mack is there to make the catch. The runner holds, and the United States is within two outs. In-Hobik, the shortstop, will come up. He's 1 for 3 with a single back in the seventh inning. Got him popping up to the right side. Alfaro, and there are two down. So August is within one and nailing this one down for the United States, and the anticipation of making it to the championship game is just a step away.
This United States club has to be excited right now. They realize what's in front of them. It's been a long
extensive road to the semifinal round. They are one game away, one out away, I should say, from reaching that gold medal game.
And this is a big hurdle because Soon-Chul Lee was a man who homered earlier in this game. Looking for a charge into it. A little bit inside. August has given up only four hits in the four innings he's worked. And no walks. That's important. And he seems to pitch better when there's runners on base. Nice pitch. Catches the outside corner. Crowd is fired up. They're sensing the feeling. 54,000 plus wanting the pitch that'll send the United States into the championship game against Japan. Just got a piece of it. Fouled it back. Donnie says, I wanted that one. Ground ball, Cory has it. Snyder's throw in time to McGwire. And the United States has advanced to the championship game. Let's enjoy it with them. George, I like the way Cory Snyder fielded that baseball, threw the baseball up in the air and said, I got it. Rammed it over the first base for the final out. You gotta feel happy for Rod Dedeaux. Been through so much in the amateur athletic field, accomplished so much for the sport of baseball. Now his club is going to the final of this demonstration tournament.
On August, getting congratulations from the Korean team and from his teammates. Chung-Ok Kim, the manager, and the rest of the Koreans coming over to congratulate. They had a great series as well. The United States beats Korea 5-2, and we are on to the championship game.